Who wouldn't be skeptical when a man claims to have spent an entire weekend with God? In a shack, no less. And not just any shack. This was the shack. What I'm about to tell you is a little on the, well, it's a lot on the fantastic side. But that doesn't necessarily mean it's not true. Mac was born in the Midwest. Farm boy in an Irish-American family, committed to calloused hands and rigorous rules.
Look at me! Look at me! Listen!
His father was an elder in the church.
What are you looking at, boy?
Closet drinker. Especially when the rain didn't come or came too early.
Yeah.
Most times in between.
I just took an apple pie out of the oven. Come have a slice.
No, thanks.
That wasn't a question. Here you go.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Look at me, baby. Daddies aren't supposed to do that to their kids. It ain't love. You understand?
What do I do?
Talk to God. He's always listening.
Sing with me. As those who feel led make their way to the altar.
That Sunday when the preacher called, he knew he couldn't stay silent any longer.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but
I'm sorry.
That's all right. Just tell him what you're sorry for.
I can't make him stop. I try, but when he drinks, he beats my mom. I try to protect her, but I can't.
Why do you make me do this, boy? Why do you embarrass me in front of my people? Say it.
Obey your parents and everything, Philip!
The beating lasted well into the night. What happened after that, Mac doesn't like to talk about. Let's just say pain has a way of twisting us up inside. And making us do the unthinkable. Thirteen is way too young to be all grown up. The secrets we keep have a way of clawing their way to the surface.
You're okay.
Mac and Nan have been married for 18 mostly happy years. She's the glue that holds that family together.
Actually, if we get out of here in the next 3 minutes, we might make it on time. Kids! Christy, hold still for 1 second. Pause.
Josh!
Okay.
Josh!
Forget it.
Shut. Are you ready?
Yeah, why?
Well, Nan, there's something wrong with Josh. He's combed his hair and he smells nice.
He's trying to impress Allie Taylor.
No,
who?
I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Well, who's Allie?
I don't care who it is. If she gets his hair on time, she's got my blessing.
But if God is always with us, why does he care if we're late for church?
Yeah, she's got a point.
Yeah. God cares because your mama cares.
Hey, come on.
That was a nice try, you little rascal.
Good morning. Hi, guys.
Hi.
Mac, did you catch the game last night?
Since when do I control the remote?
I hear one day you get it back.
The crazy thing is, I'm starting to like her shows.
I met Mac at church.
Morning.
10 years ago. Back then, he didn't know God the way Nan did. If his relationship was wide, Nan's was deep. She called God Papa and talked to him like an old friend, which was never something Matt could relate to. But together, they still managed to create what most would call a good life. But all that changed in an instant. And a great sadness came uninvited.
I haven't seen a storm like this in 30 years. It's a good thing Nan and the kids are off the roads. You want some help over there? Grab my shovel, knock it out in no time.
I'm okay. Shouldn't take too long. Thanks for the gas.
How about some dinner tonight? Maggie made chicken pot pie.
Maybe next time.
All right.
Thanks.
All right.
Dad, catch.
There's no room.
Hey, you might want to put this somewhere where you can find it.
First aid. If we get stung by bees, we'll use river mud, right, Josh?
Yeah. Mom, are you sure you can't get out of your seminar?
Come on, come on. You guys are going to have a great time.
I have faith in your dad's mothering skills.
You do?
Hey. Hey, 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 young lady. What do you got there?
My insect collection.
Your what?
Hey, are you pecking bugs?
No, Daddy.
No?
This is Dixie and Donna the Crappy Beetles. Wanda the Walking Stick, and that's Carl the Caterpillar.
Carl the Caterpillar, I like it.
Can I take them, please?
We can't leave Carl the Caterpillar behind.
Not a good idea. No.
I'm sorry. I tried.
Summer's last hurrah. It's gonna be an awful lonely weekend around here.
I'll bring you back a 6-pound brown.
All right, none of that store-bought stuff. I can tell the difference.
Hey, Willie, have you got a moment?
Sure.
Cool.
We gotta go.
Hey, a little patience, please. Kids?
Okay, okay, come on.
Jeez.
Okay.
Good-looking bunch, yeah.
Okay, get out of here. Goodbye.
Hey, kids. Kids, look there. You remember?
The falls, Daddy. We have to stop.
Let's go see the waterfall.
Come on.
Stop them. We gotta get to the campground before dark.
Well, have you told Missy the story of the Indian princess?
What princess?
Come on, Dad. You have to. You have to tell her the story. You have to go back.
Please.
We can't go back. We can't just keep pulling off every exit.
The answer is no. Long time ago, there was an Indian princess.
What did she look like?
Well, she was very pretty.
What color was her hair?
Like this. Do you want me to tell you this story? Okay. Well, this princess was the only daughter of the eldest chief. And he was the leader of a great tribe. She one summer, a terrible sickness spread through the land. It was so fierce, even the strongest warriors fell ill. They were on the verge of death. So all the chiefs met to see what they could do. Princess's father, he told of a prophecy. Illness could only be stopped if the daughter of a chief gave up her life for her people. After a long debate, they knew they couldn't ask for such a sacrifice. And the princess, when she heard about this prophecy, she knew what she had to do because she loved her people so much. One morning, she climbed up to those rocks. And without hesitation, she jumped. The next morning, great healing came over the tribe. The sick began to rise from their beds. Everyone rejoiced. But the chief knew that his daughter was missing. He knew what she'd done. His heart broke. Tears rolled down his cheek. He cried out, asking for his daughter's sacrifice to be remembered. The Great Spirit was so moved by his tears that he answered his prayers. And water began to fall right there. That's how Multnomah Falls was created.
A little patience, please.
You got that off your mommy, didn't you?
Careful near the water. Hey, let me give you a hand with that. There we go.
I'm Mac.
Emil, that's my wife, Vicky.
Those two yours?
They are. They
seem to be getting on.
Yeah, well, I suppose we should too. This whole thing's gonna get awkward. Hey, listen, we're camped right up here. If you want to come by later, help us light some marshmallows on fire.
That sounds good.
Great. We'll see you later.
The other day,
I saw a bear.
Away up there.
He looked at me.
I looked at him.
He sized up me.
You have a nice family.
Thank you. You as well.
Daddy, we need to say our prayers to Papa.
I'll be right there.
Papa?
Yes. This is my wife's nickname for God.
I like that.
Mine's a little too familiar for my taste, but
Daddy.
Kids love it. I'll be back.
Jesus dying isn't a legend.
It's in the Bible, so it must be true.
Is the Great Spirit another name for Papa?
He is a spirit. And he is great, right?
Then how come he's so mean?
Why'd you say that?
The Great Spirit made the princess jump off the cliff and made Jesus die on the cross. Don't you think that's mean?
I tell you what. When we get home, your mom will have a good answer for you.
Daddy, will I ever have to jump off a cliff?
No, honey. You will never have to jump off a cliff.
Would God ask me to?
No. He won't ask you that either.
Okay. Good night, Daddy.
She asks good questions, doesn't she?
Yeah, she sure does. She's a special girl. You both are.
Thanks. Love you, Dad.
I love you. Start packing up.
Do you think the princess should have red boots or blue?
Time to come in!
Daddy, red or blue?
What else is she wearing?
She's wearing a red dress like mine.
And red it is.
It's beautiful, honey.
Daddy! Look at me!
Stop!
Gosh! Gosh! Gosh!
Josh!
There we go. There we go. That's it.
Missy! Hey, you can come out, honey. Everyone's fine now.
Where'd you go, huh? You see Missy?
You check your camp?
Yeah, she's probably with my girls.
You okay?
Where is she, Dad?
She'll be here somewhere. We'll find her.
Okay?
Not here. My girls are gone, too. Check those bathrooms and showers, and I'll check those. All right.
Missy!
Emily! Sorry, have you seen the little girl?
I didn't see anybody.
Missy?
Vicky! I found them.
Where's Missy?
Sorry, Mac, they haven't seen her.
Missy! Missy!
Oh, God, he's
gone. We need to know if there's anything different from the way you remember it. Anything out of place. He said she was there.
That lady about that pin.
That's not Missy?
No. Definitely not.
I think it's probably one or two places falls. I think it's either the lake or the mountain.
Yeah, I'm going to check this mountain.
Yeah.
Someone please tell me what's going on.
Sorry, Mr. Phillips. Apparently, there's a guy the feds have been pursuing for years. They think he's responsible for abducting at least 5 young girls.
You think he took my Missy?
We don't know anything for sure.
We have a possible suspect sighting. Man in a truck near the Imnahav roadblock. Hero is setting up base camp in Joseph. Over.
Tell him we'll be there within the hour. Mr. Phillips. Go get your kids.
There isn't one person in this room who doesn't care about your Missy. We're doing everything in our power to bring her back safely to you.
Mom? It's okay. I'm here. I'm here.
Team's found the truck in the mountains.
Okay.
Chopper's waiting, sir.
Mac, you okay? You okay?
Okay.
Okay.
We gotta go.
Okay.
Dad. We're just sitting down for dinner.
What the heck is this?
What?
Is this some kind of sick joke?
You think I wrote this?
Mentions the shack, signed Papa. Who else knows that?
Mac, I would never kid about that. No. Where'd you get it?
It was in my mailbox. Somebody put it there.
Let's do it this way. Should we call the police?
Call the police and say what? The letter showed up in my mailbox with no tracks in the snow, and it might have been signed by God.
There were no tracks.
Just forget it.
Mac. Mac!
Champ.
You okay?
Yeah, I just slipped on the ice last night.
Let me see.
That's fine. It's just a little bump.
What's that?
It's just a work thing. Where's Kate?
Well, she'll be in a minute. I tried calling me this morning.
You did? Must have really been out.
Hey, Dad. Dad, can I go finish my homework at Allie's?
You've seen the weather out, right?
It's only two streets away.
Another time. Hey, you. Hey.
What?
I just wanted to say hi.
Hi. Can I go?
You at Orleans.
Same as always. She comes out of her shell for a minute and then retreats. So I'm gonna take her to my brother's this weekend. He knows a counselor that we could try and thought maybe you could join us.
I'm pretty sure that's the last thing she wants. Yeah, I think it's best if it's just you guys. I gotta get changed and run some errands in town.
Mac?
Yeah?
Don't forget we love each other.
And you don't know anything about it.
There's no stamp.
No.
Well, if it's not stamped, it's not delivered. Well, you want your mail while you're here?
What do you need a four-wheel drive for? Mac. Come on. we've been friends for a long time. Just shoot straight with me. Is this about that note? You're not thinking about going back there, are you? Well, have you talked with Nan about this at all?
No, I don't want to upset her. She's barely holding it together right now.
Have you prayed about it?
I just wanted your truck.
You know this isn't a good idea, all right? I mean, what if it is that guy? And he's trying to get you out there for who knows what reason?
We don't know that yet.
You ever think about the other possibility?
What? You think it's God?
You're the one who said there were no tracks in the snow.
Maybe it'd been out there for a few days and I didn't see it. No, no, no. It's completely crazy. But I gotta do something, and this is all I got.
Okay. But I'm gonna go with you.
Sure, fine. I hope it goes well with her.
Yeah. I hope it goes well with you, too. Sweetie, can you take this?
Yeah. Thanks. Text me when you get there.
Look, I know that you're wrestling with something. And it's okay if you don't know how to talk about it. It's just that we've lost so much already.
Tent, bags, food, Coleman lantern, snowshoes. Just in case.
Where's your pole?
I didn't know we were going fishing.
Well, we should probably have something to do when we finally figure out I've lost my mind.
All right, I'll grab my stuff.
Oh.
You couldn't even let us have her body buried properly. You coward.
Pretty chilly out here, huh? Got the fire going inside if you want to warm up. Come on, Mac. I know someone would love to see
Mackenzie Allen Phillips. My.
Look at you.
Do I know you?
Not very well, but we can work on that. I've been so looking forward to this, to finally see you face to face. Can I take your coat? And that gun. We wouldn't want anyone to get hurt, now would we? I understand. It's confusing. We all do. You will do this on your terms and time. How about some introductions? I'm Alusia. I have a lot of names, but that's one of my favorites. Or if you want, you can call me what Nan does.
You know Nan?
Oh, yes. Very well.
Are you saying that you're...
I am.
The I am.
I am that I am. Look at that. Already quoting scripture. And you bet my son.
Great to see you, Mac. Your son? Of course.
And, son, are you?
Sarah who?
Sarah. It means a breath of wind.
Right. So, which one of you is...
I am. And you have no idea how much I love you. It's okay, baby. Let it go.
We all collect things we value, don't we? I collect tears.
Alright. It's good to meet you guys. I'll be right back.
You're not supposed to do anything. You're free to do whatever you like. You can go fishing or hiking, help Sarah in the garden, or you can go talk to Papa in the kitchen. Your choice. I know this is overwhelming. I'll be finishing up a project in the workshop if you want to stop by.
Okay.
Remember that smell? Griff. Your mother's perfume. She loves you more than you can possibly know.
Am I dead?
Do you feel dead?
You knew I would come, didn't you?
Of course I did.
Was it free not to come?
I'm not interested in prisoners. You're free to walk out that door right now.
Why did you bring me back here?
Because here's where you got stuck.
Wearing a dress.
Excuse me?
I always pictured you with a white beard.
I think that's Santa. After what you've been through, I didn't think you could handle a father right now. Here, make yourself useful. Chris, Helms, fold back, rotate. All there is to it. I know what a great gulf there is between us, Mac. You may not believe it, but I am especially fond of you. Mm-hmm. I want to heal that wound that's grown inside you and between us. There's no easy answer that'll take your pain away. No instant fix that's enduring. Life takes a bit of time and a lot of relationship.
Relationship? Mm-hmm. You're the Almighty God, right? You know everything. You're everywhere all at once. You have limitless power. Yet somehow, you let my little girl die. When she needed you most, you abandoned her.
I never left her.
If you are who you say you are, where were you when I needed you?
Son, when all you see is your pain, you lose sight of me.
Stop talking. Say that you will help me when you couldn't help her because of you. She's gone. Unless you can change that, I will never be free.
The truth sets everyone free, Mackenzie. And the truth has a name. He's over in his woodshed right now, covered in sawdust.
Truth? I know that story. You left him, too. Seems like you have a bad habit of turning your back on those you supposedly love.
I'm not who you think I am.
He said it himself. My God, why hast thou forsaken me?
No, Mac. You misunderstand the mystery.
Thank you.
what my son chose to do didn't cost us both dearly. Love always leaves a mark. We were there together. I never left and I never left you. I never left Miss. He's a beauty, isn't he? Created to fly. You, on the other hand, were created to be loved. Living unloved is like clipping a bird's wings. Pain has a way of doing that to us. If it's left unresolved, you can forget what you were created for. It's not something I want for you. That's why you're here, Mackenzie. This is your flying lesson. Dinner's almost ready. Josh has a girlfriend now.
You mean Ellie? I like her.
Me too. I'm especially fond of that laugh of hers.
She's cute.
He's still having a hard time believing this is real.
You think?
How's Kate doing?
We used to be close, but... Oh, my God. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to...
Well, it's okay. I didn't make it. It is good.
Best meal I've had. Ever. Dreaming or otherwise.
Thank you.
Let me ask you something. I've been telling you all about Josh and Kate and Ann. But if you're real, then you already know everything I'm gonna say before I even say it, right?
Yes, but... We choose to listen to everything you have to say as if it was for the first time. We love getting to know your kids through your eyes.
I'll wash you dry.
I'll take this round. Why don't you show Max some of your handiwork?
Want to take a look?
What's this one? Incredible. Now I get that you're all connected. I feel way more relaxed around you.
That's probably because I'm human.
But you're God too, right?
I'm the best way any human can relate to Papa and Sergio. To see me is to see them.
You're all so different. Leisure is not what I expected at all. And Sergio, oh, jeez.
Serious creativity. Action. The breath of life. She is my spirit. Love is meant to exist within a relationship, Mac. That's all we want to have with you. Even if you can't see it. You are in the center of our love and purpose. As beautiful as all this is, it's nothing compared to how we see it.
Morning, Mac. You like Neil Young.
I am especially fond of him. I'll just leave, baby.
No, dreams are important. They can be a way of opening a window, letting the bad air out.
Is there anyone you're not especially fond of?
Nope. Haven't been able to find any. Guess that's just the way I am.
Don't you get mad at him?
Well, sure. What parent doesn't?
That's when your whole wrath thing comes in, right?
My what?
Your wrath.
You lost me there.
Come on. Everybody knows you punish the people who disappoint you.
Nope. I don't need to punish people. Sin is his own punishment. As difficult as it is for you to accept, I'm in the middle of everything you perceive to be a mess, working for your good. That's what I do.
How can you say that? Of all the pain and suffering in the world, what possible good comes from a little girl being murdered by a sick monster? See, you may not cause those things, but you certainly don't stop them.
Mackenzie, you're trying to make sense of your world based on a very incomplete picture. It's like looking through the knothole of your pain. The real underlying flaw in your life is that you don't think that I'm good. I am. And if you knew me and how much I love you, then even when you don't understand, you could know that I am at work in your life for good. And then you would trust me.
Trust you? Why would I do that? My daughter is dead. There's nothing you can say that will ever justify what happened to her.
For the way out? If you are looking for your truck, it's up that way, just beyond the trees. You might need these, though.
Thanks.
Just to be clear, we're not justifying anything. We'd like to heal it, if you'd let us. Before you go, there's something in the garden I was hoping you could help me with. For tomorrow's celebration.
A celebration?
If you want to know, you'll stick around.
This is wild.
That isn't the word in your head.
Okay, this is a mess.
It is, isn't it?
So beautiful.
There's something very special I want to plant here tomorrow. Prepare the ground. We have to dig up all the roots or they'll return and harm the new growth.
But this is gorgeous.
Mm-hmm. You can start over there.
Okay.
Careful. That one's deadly.
What's it doing here if it's poisonous?
You're presuming that poison is bad.
Uh-huh.
On its own, the sap from this twig would kill you. But combine it with the nectar from this flower, and suddenly it contains incredible healing properties. Let me ask you, how confident are you in your ability to discern good from evil?
Usually pretty obvious.
And your basis for something being good is what?
Well, if it helps me, or the people that I love.
And evil?
It's harmful. If it hurts someone I care about.
So, pretty much you are the judge.
Yeah, I guess.
Have you ever been wrong? Or changed your opinion over time?
Sure.
And there are billions like you. Each determining what you think is good and evil.
And when your good clashes with your neighbor's evil, arguments ensue, wars break out, because all insist on playing God. You weren't meant to do any of that. All on your own. This was always meant to be a conversation between friends. What do you think?
It's still a mess.
Yes, it is, Mac. Wild, wonderful, and perfectly in process. This mess is you.
So, you decided to stay?
Thinking about it.
Sarah, you can be very persuasive, huh?
If only I was smart enough to understand a word she said.
So, if you're up for a walk, there's something on the far side of the lake I'd like to show you. I just have to finish up in the shed and I'll meet you down there. You can take the boat out if you want. Left my pole in it if you're feeling lucky. It's okay.
Why are you doing this to me?
This isn't me.
You told me to come out here.
Mac, this is happening inside you. You're letting it consume you and you don't have to. Just take a deep breath and listen to my voice.
Don't look at it, Mac. Look here.
Missing!
Don't think about the past. Don't think about the pain.
Look at me. Everything is gonna be okay. Look at me.
Trust me, none of this can hurt you.
Just keep your eyes on me. Breathe.
Good, Mac. I'm not going anywhere.
Now, let's get you out of this boat.
What?
You heard me.
this is not funny.
I'm not joking. You can do this.
I can't.
Not on your own, you can't.
I was thinking.
No, Mac. You're imagining a future without me, and that future does not exist. I promise to go with you always, right? And I'm right here.
How are you doing?
I'm still freaking out.
Huh. Looks like we've got company.
Look at this. Well, see? What a beauty.
Must be over 2 feet long. We're trying to catch him for weeks.
Why don't you just command him by joke?
What's the fun in that?
You know, you don't really fit all the religious stuff that I was taught.
Religion? Religion is way too much work. I don't want slaves. I want friends. Family to share life with.
About following the rules and working to be a good Christian.
Think about it, Mac.
I don't know exactly what you call a Christian.
How am I?
I guess you're not.
I don't care what you call them. I just want to see people change by knowing Papa. To feel what it's like to be truly loved.
I don't think I've ever felt that.
Put your shoes back on, I'll show you how you can.
Follow the path until it ends, and then keep going.
You're not coming.
Mm-mm. This is a path only you can take.
I thought you said you'd never leave me.
And I meant it. Trust me. Don't forget what you've learned. I'll be waiting for you right here.
Hello? Anyone? Sorry, I... You are?
I am Wisdom. Do you understand why you're here?
Not really, but I'm kind of getting used to that.
Today's a serious day, with serious consequences. You're here for judgment.
Judgment. They said I wasn't dead.
You're not.
Then what is this?
You don't believe that God is good?
Is Misty his child?
Of course.
Then no. I don't think God loves his children very well.
If that's what you believe, come, sit.
You can judge me fine from there.
Judge you?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have something to confess?
You know what I did.
Yes, but you're not the one on trial. Today, you are the judge.
What?
Why are you surprised? You spent your whole life judging nearly everyone and everything, their actions and motivations, as if you could even know them. You make snap judgments just by the color of someone's skin, their clothes, their body language. By all accounts, you're a well-practiced expert, Mackenzie. Sit.
All right. So who am I supposed to judge?
There must be at least a few who are to blame for all the pain and suffering in the world, right? What about the selfish? The greedy? Those who harm others? Murderers? Drug dealers, terrorists, guilty?
Yeah.
What about men who beat their wives?
Here, what did you say?
Or fathers who beat their sons to alleviate their own suffering?
Let's not do this.
Should that man be judged?
Yeah. I don't.
Shut!
What about this boy?
What about him?
Would you judge him?
He's a kid.
But you already have. That boy is your father.
Yes, sir.
No. What about the man who preys on innocent little girls?
Daddy! Daddy!
Okay, that's enough.
Is that man guilty?
I would damn him to hell.
And what of his father? The man who twisted him into this deviant monster?
I would damn him to.
How can you stop there? Doesn't the legacy of brokenness go all the way back to Adam? And what about God? Isn't he at fault? He set all this in motion. Especially if he knew the outcome.
You want me to say it? Absolutely. God is to blame.
Well, if it's so easy for you to judge God, you must choose one of your children to spend eternity in heaven. The other will go to hell.
Can't
do what? I'm only asking you to do something you believe God does. So, who will go to hell? You could choose Kate. She said some pretty hurtful things. She shuts you out. You're not even sure if she loves you anymore. Or you could choose Josh. He's being disobedient, sneaking out, lying to you. You didn't know that. Mackenzie, make your choice.
I don't do this anymore. I can't do this.
Can't do what?
I can't. I won't.
You must.
This isn't a game.
You have to.
You know what? This isn't fair.
You must.
It isn't fair. Instead of them, I'll take their place. You take me. I'll go in their place. You leave my kids alone and you take me.
Mackenzie, you've judged your children worthy of love. Even if it costs you everything. Now you know Papa's heart.
You know, I don't understand is how God can love Missy and put it through so much horror. She was innocent.
I know.
Does he use her to punish me? Because that's not fair. And she didn't deserve it. And my wife and my children didn't deserve it. Now I might, because I'm...
Is that who your God is, Mackenzie? No wonder you're drowning in great sorrow. God isn't like that. This was not God's doing.
Yeah, stop it.
He doesn't stop a lot of things that cause him pain. What happened to Missy was the work of evil. And no one in your world is immune from it. You want the promise of a pain-free life. There isn't one. As long as there is another will in this universe, free not to follow God, evil can find a way in.
There's gotta be a better way.
There is. But a better way involves trust.
Judge anymore.
She can't hear you.
Did she see me?
No. But she knows you're here.
Is she okay?
More than you know.
Forgive me.
For what?
Couldn't save her. Couldn't get to her in time.
Missy doesn't think that. And neither does Nan or Papa. It's time to let that go.
How was it?
Terrible. And wonderful.
I'm very proud of you, my friend.
Thank you. For letting me see her. It wasn't my idea.
Always works better when we do it together, don't you think?
Catch a few rays.
Honey, you have no idea how much I'm doing right now.
Papa.
Yes, Mackenzie.
I've been pretty hard on you. Sorry.
It's okay. It's in the past now, where it belongs. Maybe we can start growing together without it.
I like that. Thank you for letting me see Missy.
It was entirely my pleasure. I can't begin to describe the joy it gave me to see you two together. And Missy's a special girl. You understand now. I can work incredible good out of unspeakable tragedies. That doesn't mean I orchestrate the tragedy.
Everything I felt in my heart towards you. Why would you keep working on me?
Because that's what love does.
I don't really understand relationships, do I? You still love me anyway.
Men, such idiots sometimes.
I hear God just call me an idiot.
If the shoe fits. Yes, sir. If the shoe fits.
Freshen up, Matt. You got a big night ahead.
Someone gonna tell me where we're going?
Look around, Mackenzie. Don't forget to enjoy the journey.
Here we are.
This is it?
To your eyes. Just for tonight. We'd love for you to get a glimpse of what we see. Children from every tongue, tribe, and nation. What you call personality and emotion, we see as color and light.
What's happening with that one? Why is he focused on us?
He's focused on you.
I'm so sorry for everything. I was blind and I couldn't see you. I couldn't see anyone.
I know. I was scared. I didn't know what to do.
Son, I forgive you. You become the father I could never be. I'm so proud of you.
Can you ever forgive me?
Go home.
Mac, wake up. It's time for us to go. Son.
You're messing with me, aren't you?
Oh, always. For what we have to do today, you're gonna need a father. almost there. We're here to do something that's going to be very painful for you.
Please don't.
Son, we're on a healing trail to bring closure to this part of your journey.
You want me to forgive him?
Mm-hmm.
He killed my daughter. I want to hurt him. I want him to hurt like he hurt me. I want you to hurt him.
I know you do. But he too is my son, and I want to redeem him.
Redeem him. He should burn in hell.
So we're back to you as the judge.
So you just let him get away with it?
Nobody gets away with anything. Everything bears consequences.
What he did
was horrible. I'm not asking you to excuse what he did. I'm asking you to trust me, to do what's right, and to know what's best.
And then what?
Forgiveness doesn't establish your relationship. It's just about letting go of his throat. Mac, the pain inside is devouring you, robbing you of joy and crippling your capacity to love.
I can't.
You're not stuck because you can't. You're stuck because you won't. You don't have to do this alone. I'm here with you.
I don't know how.
Just say it out loud. Such a joy.
I'm still angry.
Of course you are. No one lets go all at once. You might have to do it a thousand times before it gets any easier. But it will. bring Missy home.
I don't know where you're going, but I'll meet you there. I can't blame you for leaving, but it's still not fair.
Dog.
And when I don't know what to say, I sing about you. Now I don't know what to do now that you're not here. I don't know how to love, don't know how to feel. But I don't want to believe. I'll believe in you. I'll believe in you.
Does a body good to let the healing waters flow. Those are your tears, Mackenzie. We've been collecting them for a long time.
It's all think about you.
Here you go. Mackenzie, we have something for you to consider. You can remain here with us, or go home to Nan and your children.
Either way, we promise to be with you, always.
What about Missy? If you stay, we'll be with her this afternoon.
If you go, you'll be leaving her behind. But only for now.
Well, what does she want?
She'd love to see you today. But she lives in a place where there's no impatience, so she doesn't mind waiting.
Everything about being here has been so remarkable. Back home, I go to work. Try to be a good person. Love my family. But, does what I do really matter?
Absolutely. Mac, you are important. And so is everything you do.
Every time you love, Mac, or forgive, with every act of kindness, the universe changes for the better.
Mm. If anything matters, then everything matters.
Then I want to go home.
Well, can we ask you to do something for us when you go? Kate needs you.
She blames herself for Missy's death.
You had your own guilt to deal with. But the time for blame is over.
When I go back, I still want you in my life.
I always was.
I always am.
I always will be.
That's good. Because I've become especially fond of you.
I love you, Mac.
Mac? Hey. Mac? Hey. Hey, buddy. You're awake.
Where am I?
You're at the hospital.
Where's Papa?
I'll go get the doctor and the family.
Okay.
She was there.
Who, Mac? Was where?
I gotta talk to Kate.
Hey.
Hey, man.
Hey.
Settle down. And Josh.
I gotta tell him.
They're here. Nurse just went to get him there in the cafeteria.
What happened?
Well, buddy, you were hit by a 40-ton semi.
Last night?
No, Friday. Right after you stole my truck.
That's impossible. I spent the weekend at the shack.
Mac, you never made it.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I made it. I was there.
Okay. Hey, bud, this is a lot to take in, all right?
I met God. Papa said to tell you he's especially fond of you.
nap?
Rest.
I know things haven't been that great between us lately. I was so lost in my own sadness that I wasn't able to help you through yours. I'm really sorry. None of this is your fault.
I never should have stood up on that boat.
You've been carrying. And I'm only beginning to learn how to let it go. And I'm hoping that this is something that we can learn to do together. Doesn't matter what you're going through, you never have to do it alone.
You too, Dad.
I love you so much, girl.
That afternoon, Mac told Nan everything. Over the next few weeks, Mac improved rapidly.
Our God is an awesome God. He
I'm sure there are some who wonder if everything really happened the way Mac recalls.
Or if any of it happened at all.
You'll have to decide for yourself, I suppose. But the changes I see every day in my friend are evidence enough for me.
Here.
Well, he said the bass are biting. He'd give me 10 bucks if I beat his 5-pounder.
That's easy money.
Can you bring a pole for me?
Take your pick. Got one for you, too, if you're feeling lucky.
Oh, you're on.
The great sadness is gone. Mac experiences most days with a profound sense of joy. He loves larger than most. He's quick to forgive, and even quicker to ask forgiveness. He has become a child again. Or maybe the child he was never allowed to be, abiding in simple trust and wonder. And it wouldn't surprise me if every now and then Mac takes off his shoes just to see if, well, you know.
Just like a tear to go and blur out everything. Ain't it just like glass to fall and break so easily? Ain't it just like love to leave a mark on the skin and underneath? Yeah, when the pain goes and shadows everything.
Keep your
all the grace sometimes. Ain't it the saint who picks up the pieces left behind? Yeah, and it's human to hurt the one you hurt the one and you love the most, and you can't find the sun.
Keep your eyes on me. Keep your eyes.